I originally came into this flat Earth subject simply because I thought I could debunk it. My first few videos that I did, I was going to put them out claiming, hey, this is the proof that the Earth has curvature. But I decided to investigate it further because there was a few things that really didn't make sense as I was viewing objects at a distance, and it has partly to do with this mirroring effect that occurs when you get past this visible waterline. You can obviously tell something's going on out there, and what I call it is mirroring, and that mirroring doesn't allow you to see things that are above this visible waterline, like these rocks that you see sticking out of the water. They're sticking out of the water, and you can actually see their mirror image underneath them. These aren't mirages. If anything, it's more of an illusion that we get from some of these. Now, throughout my journey of doing these boat videos, I've noticed a lot of different things. It has to do with you know, reflection, which is kind of the mirroring effect, diffraction, which is the bending of light. But more importantly, you know, science wants to call it a mirage. You know, this is what most of the trolls that come on my channel tell me, that I'm watching a mirage. And I tell them, no, I'm looking at an illusion. And what's the illusion? Well, the boat isn't the illusion. The boat is there. The illusion is the water itself above this waterline, the visible waterline. As you see here, you see the birds setting on the rocks. And if my camera was a little higher, you'd probably see those birds directly underneath the rocks too. Because of that waterline being right at the edge, you didn't see those birds. But you know, throughout my journeys, I've seen a lot of things, and this presentation, and this is going to be part one to my presentation, because I did so much footage this day, I couldn't put it all in one video. Matter of fact, there might be three or four parts to this, only because, you know, if I make these videos too long, a lot of people don't want to watch them, but you know, observations are very important for us to watch if we want to learn from them and actually see what's going on. People will deny this, and my whole objective is the people that deny it need to relook at it, rethink it. And some of my video proof will show you that these objects don't go over this curve. This waterline is not the curvature of Earth. This is not where the curve starts and it goes down. If anything, it's going farther out, and these mirroring or so-called mirages, you can see they will resolve and you will see things in the resolution. And that's the problem, is you know, the camera has a hard time resolving an image that's at the razor's edge. And this is my whole point of making this particular video, because I've got some proof toward the end of it that will make you really think about what you're seeing out on the water. And hopefully this will change some minds, change some opinions, and get people to investigate this a little further. Science is not going to give us the answers that we want, because for some reason, some of the science wants to hide the obvious. And some of my videos are going to make the obvious more obvious. It's going to stand out to you. Now, you look at these people in this boat and you wonder, you know, why you can't see the bottom end of that boat. And we'll get into that discussion as I go through my videos. and show you what I'm talking about. All right. So this is really important to me, and it should be important to the viewer to have their own opinion and decide what they're seeing. All right. I'm going to let my video go into me talking. And I did insert a few pictures into this, and I will explain to you what these pictures are. These were taken February 4th, 2017 from 11:24 a.m. to 12:10 p.m. And I did put up a little chart of the tides too in these videos, so you can look at that. To see what the tide settings were for those hours.
Got to focus it in better out there. I'm gonna take a picture of where I'm at on the beach here with my cell phone.
Alright, here's my tripod, and it stands 5.5 feet up to the lens of the camera. And I took two pictures at two different angles. Well, kind of the same angle, but a little bit different. And then I'm gonna show you the picture of what the tides were that day. And this particular day, it was fairly calm. A few little gusts of wind were blowing by, but as you can see, the water, it's pretty calm out there. And see, this is the tides for that day. You can see where I was at in that tide chart, and you make up your own mind from there. All right, as I go along here, I'm leaving some of my video audio the same, and I try to explain it as I go along. Explain the water plane. Very interesting. But you'll see this boat that'll come in the frame in here in a second. And what I want to explain is that this next little tiny boat that you'll see, it's actually going away from me. So as it goes away, it will pretty much go to that vanishing point. But, you know, people want to know why, you know, some of these boats look like they're half cut off on the bottom. You have to realize that you cannot see the waves farther out you go. So this illusion is because of these waves that you cannot see is cutting out because of my angle, the lower end of the boat. So these waves are like a rock or something, an object closer, blocking out the farther image. So because you can't see these waves, they're actually what is blocking out the lower half of that boat. And as this boat gets farther from me, it will go to what I call the vanishing point, or it gets so distorted that you cannot see it and my camera can't resolve it. And what causes this mirroring effect is a lot of light being shined on the water from the sun. So even sometimes you can look and you can see these birds flying around. Now, we know those birds aren't an illusion or a mirage. They're real birds. It's just that they're so far away that the camera can barely pick them up. So again, you know, you see those birds fly by the boat. And then you see this one bird's closer, which is funny because you'll see a pelican fly in the screen and he's up much closer, but he'll block out almost the whole background on this. So take that into consideration, how these images are. There's the pelican. And you know, that was the pelican real close blocks out almost the whole screen. So, you know, this is where these objects are getting distorted, or this illusion's taking place that, you know, it's going beyond the curvature of Earth. It's not the curvature of Earth that's making these boats disappear. These boats are disappearing due to the fact, again, that you cannot see these waves. And they're actually what's blocking the boat out, and the light from the sun, the light from the mirror being reflected. You got to think that anything over this waterline, a visible waterline, is a mirror. Now watch this boat as it goes along and it shuts down. When this boat shuts down, it sinks into the water. All right. And later on, I'll show you a slow motion video where I catch one that's really interesting catch, because the boat's going slow. You can see how the boat's lower end is sunk into the water, and it's like sinking into a mirror, where you cannot see that visible water line that's surrounding this boat. And again, you got to think, when you're in a boat and you're going slow, it's kind of the ass end sunk down, the nose is up, but this is where we can't see it, all due to the fact of the light glaring off of this mirroring water. This is where it gets kind of confusing. And when I first did some of my videos, I was thinking to myself, well, here's a curvature. But before opening my trap, I wanted to investigate what was causing what I was seeing. And it's not the curvature of Earth that's causing these boats to appear to disappear over the curvature of Earth. And I have some more footage. I did a lot of footage this particular day. So again, that's why I can't put it all on one video. I think people get bored sometimes watching observations, and they'll just turn it off and go on about their business. But I don't make these just for the deniers. I do make them for the flat earthers too, so they can use any of my videos they want to help show this flat earth is flat. Water, sea level, it's all the same. And this is where my journey and my opinions are going to kind of go all into one, my theory of what's going on. And I would like anybody to try to debunk this, because what you're seeing is an illusion, but the boats aren't the illusion. It's the water that is that illusion. It's like being in a house of mirrors. Now, there's another boat coming in here, and you'll see he's up on plane two. And as he's coming in, you see the front end of his boat. He's turned sideways. And when they're turned sideways, you get more detail of the boat. Now, you see the distortion in it, but now he just cut down, and the whole nose of his boat sunk in. Now, you get to see the tip of his boat, which I think that's his trolling motor. And then you see the back of his boat, which is the motor, and then of course you see the middle of the boat, but the rest of the boat's down below those waves. If you've ever been in a boat, you'll know that, you know, when they shut down the boat will sink down in the water a little bit because of its own weight, will sink it, not gravity, it's just its weight, sinks it down into the water. And because you can't see that water, those waves that you can't see, are blocking out that lower end of the boat. And it's plain and simple. It's easy to see this. Once you've done as many videos of boats on the water as I have, and I was having a little trouble with some of my focus in these, especially when I pulled back. But even watch the birds, as the birds fly by, sometimes you'll see them kind of disappear in a full steam flight. And then they pop back up. What are they going under? They're going behind a wave because they're flying low. And because of my angle, I can't pick that wave up. So It's like going behind a wall, an invisible wall that you can't see. So these are some of the things that I've noticed on doing my videos. And here's where, you know, as I zoom in, I lose my focus. And I even say that. And I'll let my video get back to, you know, its own sound, own audio.
I lost my focus. There we go.
All right, even look at this bird rack. I call it a bird rack. Everybody else around here calls it a bird rack. But you pay attention to that, too, because I did a bunch of pictures on this bird rack that I'll show at a later time, maybe. But you can tell that the very bottom of it, right at the water's edge, is reflecting the top part. And it would be upside down, and the birds will be underneath. Where the water line is kind of blocking that out, so you can't see that. It's being distorted real bad because of those wavy motions. But here, this boat goes in front of that and in front of the bird rack. And that boat was on plane. So again, you know, your distance from the one boat that just passed and this boat, there's a lot of distance in between there, but you don't see it. Because, you know, when you're viewing these long distances, it messes with your depth perception and you don't even know how far away that it is. And, you know, a lot of times you can't see the wakes of these boats when they're out on this mirror. But later on, I'll show you some footage where you do see it. And it's pretty interesting when you watch these boats coming in from a long distance away, how you'll start seeing the water splash up. You'll start seeing the wake of the boat in the mirror. And this is where I try to show people that the boat's not the illusion. The water or the mirror is what's causing this illusion of not being able to see the lower end of the boats. Otherwise, you would be able to see these boats. And at the end of my day, on this particular day, I've got some real good footage that I'll show that will even make more sense. And surprisingly, I actually lower my camera down to, I do believe, where my lens is at, it'd be about 34 inches. And then I got to take into consideration a few inches that I'm up off the actual water. I'm not right in the water, but I'm right on the edge. As you've seen in the very first pictures there, I'm not far from the edge of the water. And after a certain time, the tide starts coming back in. And at one point, I did have to pick up my tripod and move it a little bit. But, you know, this is only because I didn't want to get my tripod all wet with salt water. Even though most of it's aluminum, there are some steel screws that are in it, and I didn't want them rusting. I only spent $20 on this tripod, but it's way more expensive. I found it at a yard sale, and it was a steal for $20. So I couldn't beat it. But I kind of get bored watching this guy. But even in this video, look at the difference in the color of the water. When you get to that last bit of the visible water plane, you can see how it changes color. And then once it gets past that, it just turns into this mirror. Now, if you've ever been to on a carnival and you've seen that went into the House of Mirrors, you stand in front of one mirror, it makes you look short and squatty. Stand in another one, it makes you look skinny. You stand in another one, it makes you look all wavy and funny looking. And that's what you're going to get when you're out there on the water, because once you get above that visible water plane, it's that mirroring, it's, you know, water's not perfectly level. And see right here, you can kind of see where it's starting to break up that water line. So there is more water farther past that we just don't see it as water. We see it as a mirror. And when you have a wavy mirror, it distorts and hides things, just like in that the House of Mirrors, that fun house. So if you ever get a chance to go into one of these fun houses with the House of Mirrors, and you're standing in front of this mirror, and you see how it's distorting your body, even parts of your body become missing. This is exactly what's going on out there in the water. Now, see this boat that you see going across the back? That is a boat. That's not a mirage. It's just that you cannot see the whole thing, and because of the atmosphere, it gets distorted. Now, I'm kind of bebopping around a little bit here. I'm trying to find some good, stuff to video. But what you'll see is you'll see these little birds, on top of the water at this water's edge. You see these birds floating around out there. Now, I call them pomerans, or cormorants, but I think the actual name of them is Anna Hingo, which is a water bird. They're black. They got a long neck, big wings, and they'll kind of like shake their wings off while they're sitting on the water in order to take off and fly away. I think, they got to shake that water off because of the extra weight. But even this bird flying by right there, you see its reflection as it gets closer down to that mirror. And it's just reflecting itself. And throughout these videos that I'm going to put out, I'll show you more things. My whole thing is to let you decide what you're seeing, and if what I'm saying makes sense to you. And you got to realize that, this mirroring water is a deception to your eyes, because that horizon line is farther back there. Again, it's like trying to, film the razor's edge. The farther back an object gets on this mirroring water plane, it'll disappear. It'll cause that boat to disappear. And it's not that it's disappearing, it's getting hidden behind the waves because of the angular resolution, or the angle that I'm setting at. The farther out something gets, the sharper that angle gets. And again, it's like, trying to videotape or film the edge of a razor blade. It's hard to catch that edge, especially if you've got waves out there that you can't see that are blocking out some of your boat. I mean, it's again, it's like a hidden, an invisible wall that these boats go behind. And later on, like I said, and toward the end of my videos here, I'll be showing you how, when I lowered my camera, I was actually resolving these boats better for some reason. And that's what was exciting to me, when I came in and started looking at the footage that I got. I was actually surprised because, a man standing, 6 foot tall on a beach, they tell you can only see 3 miles. Well, what if you're only 34 inches tall, or 36 inches tall? You should only be able to see half that, shouldn't you? So how am I able to see farther and get better resolution by lowering my camera? It doesn't make sense, when you're thinking about that curvature that's supposedly out there. That's not a curvature. Again, it's the mirroring. And once you get past that water, that visible water line, the mirror is just mirroring the sky up above. That's why these things appear to be floating in the air. It's not the air that they're floating on. They're still in the water. that water is a mirror. And that's what you got to take into consideration is that mirroring, and what it causes and what you can't see due to that mirroring. So again, you know, I'm zooming around here and I'm picking up these birds right on the edge of the curvature by science standards, you know, and this is where science needs to explain to people, really what this mirroring effect does and what it causes, the cause and effects of this mirroring. Now, for the people that have watched a lot of my videos, you know that, I do these videos. Now, right here, I slowed it down. Look at this boat going real slow. You can see how its ass end sunk down. And look at the edge of where that water's coming up. That's that hidden part that you can't see. That's the part of the wave that's hiding the lower end of that boat. So right here is a good proof that you can see how you don't see, well, you can't see that water, but you can see how that wall, that mirroring, that invisible wall is hiding out the other portion of this boat. And this is why I slowed this down 2 times, was to give you a better view of it and to allow you to watch it a little bit more. Now, a lot of my videos, you can put these in slow motion and see a lot more stuff farther in the background. And you wonder what it is. Well, I can tell you that it's boats way, way out there. Now, this boat is got to be at least 2 to 3 miles away from you, if not more. And that's why I say these are a lot farther away than what they appear. And that bird right there is just on the edge of going underneath that that invisible wall. And this is where, you know, you have to be the judge of what you're seeing, not me. And I'm just showing you proof that there's a invisible area out there that it's an invisible water that actually is hiding the boats, not the curvature of Earth. So you take my proof, my evidence that I'm providing for people, and you can use it any way you like. If you want to encourage other people to watch it, you want to share it, that's great. Now, again, when I pull away, I had some problems. When I zoom back in, I lose some of that that focus. So again, I'm gonna let it go back to me talking. I may delete some of it and start talking again. I'm kind of editing these as I go along. So I'm kind of deleting out some of the audio that's in front of it that I'm either not speaking. But I do try to explain things as I'm going along, like, you know, right here. What is that out there? That's two guys standing in a boat. And, you know, you see one guy bend down and he disappears. And that's what I'm saying, that this mirroring is causing these guys to disappear, not the curvature of Earth. So here's something that I zoom in on, and you can actually see the oysters on this channel marker that's kind of right there. You can see actually where that water line is on that channel marker. But each little bit, just say each little millimeter that you get on this edge of the water, the visible water line, there's distance in there. There's a lot of distance in there. And people don't realize that this depth perception thing goes a long ways. Like these birds set in the water, they kind of disappear and then their heads pop back up. These are some of the things that I try to show people, that it is actually that invisible water wall or invisible water that creates a wall that hides the lower ends of these boats. I mean, like that boat there, you can see it sitting in the water, and this boat here coming in, it's on that invisible water plane, but look at the wakes that it's creating. These wakes are awesome. When you start getting these wakes and you see them, it, you know, it tells you that that's actually water out there. This is not a mirage. You're not seeing things. You know, you're not hallucinating. You know, you could be, I don't know, you know, what you're doing, but me, I'm not hallucinating. My camera's not hallucinating. So I'm bebopping around here, and I'm showing you these other boats that are even further out, the rocks that are right out there, and they're just barely popping out. But you can also see how, I'm not being able to resolve, and it looks kind of blurry or distorted, and that's due to the camera itself. But what you're seeing farther back there, like this particular boat, is a boat. And I'm going to follow that boat right there. And it's kind of heading right at me. That's why it kind of looks funny. But wait until it turns sideways, and then you get more detail out of that boat. And again, I think I explain it here in my own words. So I'm going to let it go back to the audio that it was on that day.
I'm talking a lot in this. Just really want you to watch the size of these boats here. Never get to see which direction they're coming out of, so what we can do is hope for the best that we'll catch one coming in. Like this one right here flashing way out there, flickering. Maybe he's coming in from way out there. Coming from. These are the ones I want to catch. I want to catch them coming in. Hopefully this is one coming in right here. He's turning. He was coming straight at me. Now look, when he turns, you can see more of the boat.
look how the boat starts to get resolved better and how you can actually start seeing more detail of the boat. That's important to notice. And also, if you do look farther back in the background, if you put these on slow motion in your YouTube settings, you'll see stuff farther back there. And that's why I say that they're boats, and they're way out there.
¿Será que el mismo voto? Usted no, porque el parque estaba así, la gente estaba bañando. No había parque, él estaba bañando.
No, there's other people down here on the shore that you can hear talking. And sometimes I like that because somebody will come up and ask me, you know, what I'm doing. And in one of my later videos, some of the next videos coming up, you'll hear somebody ask me, you know, and I'll tell them, you know, that I've only got my camera set up about 3 feet from the water. And that's going to be the killer videos that I put out. But you know, watch out. You can start seeing how, now you can start seeing the wake that this boat's causing. And you'll see another wake as he's coming in that I'll talk about too. Now watch, there's going to be another boat that goes by. And now watch how its wake, the wake from this other boat, hides the lower portion of that boat. Okay, you've seen it real quick. And just keep watching, because these are some awesome footage that I got. And this is why I love doing this, because the more I do it, the more I can explain it, the more I see how this horizon line's actually working. Even these rocks are blocking out part of that boat. So you can imagine that something behind that rock, that little rock can block out them.
He's still way the hell out there. That's what I was worried about, zooming back and losing my focus. There he goes again, picking it up on plane. Get it on plane.
Sorry I didn't get this in focus as well as I'd like, but you'll see how as he gets closer to me, he will start becoming more in focus. Because I had a fairly and good enough focus, I decided to use this part of the video to show you how the camera will actually start resolving it and picking it up better the closer it gets to me. So when I tried to refocus it, I must have not focused on the farther object. I might have focused on something in the water, or something else caused me not to get a good focus on it. But later on, I do try to solve that problem, but it ain't until later in the day that I actually get that problem solved. But you see how the bottom of this boat is still doing a little reflection in that water, even while it's out of focus, and you can actually see the wake that the boat is causing in that water that's, you know, mirroring the sky. So I continue to stay on this boat so you can watch the whole thing and watch how he starts resolving and, you know, the angular resolution starts becoming better. The closer he gets to me, more detail comes out on the boat. Okay, so just continue to watch. And I on some of these videos, I try not to say too much because actually when I'm not talking, I'm thinking about what I'm actually looking at out there. So again, you know, I really recommend that you take what I'm saying into consideration, and you tell me your opinion of what you think. Now, when I get people to come on my channel that immediately start insulting me because of what I'm saying about Earth being flat, I'm just going to delete you. But if you can come on and talk like a person, you know, be a person and not just a, you know, an insulting person, we can discuss things. But if you can't talk like a human being, then I'm not going to talk back to you like a human being. I'm just going to delete your remarks and go on about my way. These are really good videos, and my explanation are, they're really good if you are taking into consideration of what you're seeing. Even, you know, look in the background, you still see that mirroring effect occurring, even when it's out of focus. So again, you know, this is going to be part one to a few series I'm going to do. I might have, like I said, I might have 2, 3, 4 parts to it, but continue to watch this. I think it's going to make a lot of sense to a lot of people when they really start thinking about what I'm showing and how this water line works, the horizon line works, and what's causing a lot of things that occur out there. And then we'll get into even lensing.
Pretty much see where he's at right here. Zoom back.
And that kind of, I don't know how that's going to come out with me talking at the same time. But I'll let you get back to the video.